everybody. This is Michelle with Creative Operation and Country Craft Creations, and I am here today to share with you a tutorial adding to my traveler's notebook that I have started and already did a project on, and I did it for the New Year's Eve crop for Country Craft Creations, and I'll have the link below. But I wanted to do some addition to it, and also wanted to share with you kind of a beginner, real simplified way to do a junk journal. We have been asked to do some junk journal tutorials, and the designers and I, all of us, are doing something in some form. We all have different styles, we all have different ideas, and I had an idea that would work with your traveler's notebook, so I think that this would be a really fun project, and I wanted to share with you a couple ways of how to bind them and what I kind of do when I do this. Now, I have done some junk journals. I haven't done too many, but I do have some videos that I've done in the past, and I'll put links to those videos so you can kind of see what I've done. So I've done some more fancy ones. I've done some very simple ones. And today what we're going to do is kind of focus on a more simple one, and I'll kind of walk you through my process, and then I'm going to show you some stuff that we're going to make to add to your traveler's notebook. Now, this traveler's notebook I purchased from Country Craft Creations, and this was in my design team, the Simple Stories Hearth and Home collection. So I got the design team package, and I had already purchased the Graphic 45 traveler's notebook, which comes with three different notebooks, and I decorated that and already did the tutorial on that. So we're going to add to this, and I'm going to kind of share with you what I'm using it for. I have moved into it at the start of the year, excuse me, and I'll show you kind of how I use it. So anyways, we are going to get started. This is what I have left of this design team package. This is all the pattern paper that I have left. I do have some stickers and things like that left over, but as far as pattern paper, I have nothing. I have totally used everything. So I will link the tutorial that I did to show you how I covered this notebook and what I did on the inside. And so you can go back and see that, but I have moved in, like I said. I love pens. I have a ton of pens. I picked pens that I thought the colors matched the notebook because I like to match. And I haven't quite moved into this notebook yet, but with the graph paper, I thought this would be great for doing my ideas on the go for design team projects and things that I would like to make. I'm going to skip this one for just a second because this is a new edition. This notebook here, I did move into it. It's a lined notebook. This does come with the traveler's notebook. You get the three notebooks. You get the graph, the lined, and the blank. But I did do my brain dump. Now, I did move into it. I did kind of start, but you can see I have stuff like tutorials to do, to make, a list of like random things that I need to do, to buy, all that stuff. I got a shopping list here. Reminders that I got a birthday coming up, menu ideas. I mean, it's just, this is a random on the go notebook, and that's what I had intended it for. It's a traveler's notebook. Now, I don't travel anywhere, but I do go back and forth to work, and I, you know, do stuff. So I need a notebook, because if I don't write it down, I will forget. And I am not a digital girl. I can't put it in my phone and remember it. So like, I have an appointment in my phone. I need to put it on my calendar, or I will not remember it, and setting alarm will be too late. So I'm just kind of an old-fashioned girl, I guess. The last notebook is blank, and this is, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this. It could be a journal, it could be more ideas, just more lists, whatever. I did add this folder here that I had in my stash. I covered it with some of the pattern papers. I added some tags on the inside. I had this little ruler that I carry around in case I want to draw some lines. Just real simple, but in the tutorial when I did it, there was another elastic that I could use that wasn't being used from the way it was strung. You'll see that when you go to that tutorial. So that's what I did with that one. So you can hold quite a bit in this notebook, and it works really great. Then what I did was I had another traveler's notebook that was blank in my stash, and I just took some of the stickers from the collection and did kind of the subway art thing here and just created a nice little cover for it. And then on the inside, on every like third page or so, I just added another sticker and then just decorated it. So that's something you can do. This is from your stash. Now, these notebooks, You can actually make these yourself. They're super easy to make. If you have the right stuff, you can totally do this. So this is about 4 1/4 by 8 1/4. And if you just take, like I did on this one, some Kraft Artisan cardstock and put papers in it, then you can either staple. These are stapled. When you do use a stapler, I suggest getting a long arm stapler. This is a long reach and it was a few bucks, but it has well paid for itself because you can reach in 12 inches on this thing and staple. So it makes it really super easy if you're wanting to make a notebook to be able to go in and do that. And this one will go through like 25 sheets of paper. So at your local office store, if you don't have one of these in your collection and you think you're going to make some notebooks, get this because this thing is invaluable. I love it. So this one was pre-made, but this one here, I went ahead and I made myself. This I did kind of junk journal style, and I'm going to show you about that, but I did staple it. You can see if we open it up here, you can see that it is stapled here. This one here, again, this was another, junk journal style. I stapled this. Now this one, junk journal style, I sewed it. I did a pamphlet stitch. I'm going to show you how to do that in this tutorial. But real quick, before I forget, this is another folder that I created, and I'm going to show you how to make this as well. So if you have this, I'm going to show you how to make a folder. And this style folder is real simple. It has the pockets here, but it has reinforced edges, and it's really nice. And I just used some die cuts that came with my design team package, one piece of paper that I had left over that was kind of big enough. And I just layered them and decorated the front. So now I have another folder that I can put in here. And the beauty of this is that you can put this folder anywhere. So if you have any elastic, you can just pop it in there. And then you have yet another place to add any kind of loose papers that you might have in your collection. So it's really easy to add more to this book. Now, real quick, let's talk about the, we'll get to this in just a second. With making the folder, but let's talk about the junk journal. So I made two different kinds for my traveler's notebook because I don't know that anybody has really done this. I mean, I admit they probably have, I'm sure they have, but I thought, you know, junk journals are great and you can make them any size you want. You can make them big, small, and you'll see with the links below that I did, I've done quite a few. But I thought, why not do one for my traveler's notebook? This would be kind of fun. So what I did with this one is I kept it pretty, you know, kind of not distressy, not grungy, pretty clean, I guess is the word that I wanted to say. So this one here, again, decorated with the pattern paper from the collection. It matches my traveler's notebook, so that's good. And I have, you know, some new notebooks to use. But basically, I added a pocket with the pattern paper here. I cut tags out of the pattern paper to put in there, added some die cuts. But then what I did was, when I say I did it clean, I went through my papers that aren't really distressed, aren't grungy, they're white papers with, you know, just, I just went through my stuff. This is a greeting card that I put in here. This is just a piece of filler paper. Right here is an envelope, or no, excuse me, I'm sorry, this wasn't an envelope. This was a piece of copy paper that I just folded up and then created a pocket. I didn't do anything with the sides here, left it kind of open, but that's okay. This is a piece of paper from my Happy Planner. I have an envelope here and I just stuck a tag in it from the collection and I just put that in and stapled it through the middle. Another piece of filler paper. This is an accounting ledger piece that I had that I bought from the office store to use in my junk journals. Again, the other piece of a graph paper that I just folded over and just made a nice flap. Another piece of the ledger paper that I just put in sideways. So you can see that, oh, here's the envelope, and I cut the ends off and then made them pockets. So this is like a 6x9 envelope that I just put in and cut down. And you can see I stapled them. So it's really super simple and really super easy to make a junk journal. And you can use this for anything. You can journal in this. You can make notes in it. You know, whatever you want to do. So I kept this one fairly clean. And now I can just pop it into my traveler's notebook. Now this one here, I have done dyed papers before, so this one is kind of full of more distressed, antique-y, more junky looking stuff. So I did use papers to cover the front and the back. And again, this is Kraft Artisan Cardstock from Country Kraft Creations. And I made another pocket. I had tea dyed these tags and this guest check. I bought these at the office store, but then once you tea dye them or coffee dye them, then it turns them into kind of a more antique piece of paper. This is a piece of copy paper that I tea dyed, a doily that I tea dyed. I added a paper bag with a tag in here. This is that ledger paper again, tea dyed. This is an old monthly time card kind of tally book that I found at a Goodwill, I think it was. And I just took the pages out of it and I used that. Here is a piece of paper from a receipt pad that I got from an office store. Here's an old book page that's folded to make a pocket. So you can see how you can add papers to it, and when they're tea-dyed or old versus when they're super clean, you get different looks. And adding paper bags that are all nice and wrinkled and everything. Now, I didn't distress this with any other inks. You totally could do that. I didn't add stickers. I didn't add any extra embellishments. I just kept it plain because I want this in my traveler's journal, and I wanted to keep it, you know, kind of flat so I could add to it and not make it too junky. I used a die cut here to make a pocket for these two tags, and I added a piece of paper to make a pocket in the back. So this is kind of a fun thing to do. So this is, again, traveler's notebook size. They're 4 1/4 by 8 1/4. Okay. And then I want to show you, this is one that I make, and we're going to make this one in this size today, and I'll show you that. Just papers for my stash, but I did do the pamphlet stitch, and I used some kind of vintage-looking scrapbook paper and some tea-dyed paper, and then again, I'm just going to flip through this really super quick and show you all the different things that you can do with this and the looks that you can get. And again, this is just scrapbook paper. Paper bags, tea dyed papers. I'm gonna put the link, I don't know if I said this, in the description down below so you can see the tutorial that I use to learn how to tea dye. This is a pocket made out of a paper bag and then just a book page that I folded up to make it look like an envelope, but you could do, like, you know, journaling in there. You could put these two together and make a pocket. Just haven't done it yet. So this is a real simple junk journal. You can start with the bones of a junk journal and then as you go add to it. And that's what I love about junk journals. It can be anything you want it to be. So there's a couple tutorials we're going to do today. We're going to make the folder for your traveler's notebook, and then we're going to make a junk journal like this, and I'll show you how to pamphlet stitch. So let me put these to the side. And I know this is kind of a quick tutorial for you. Let me get that out of the way. So, in order to make your folder for a traveler's notebook, what I'm using is a piece of scrapbook paper that is 12 by 9, and you're going to score it on the 12. Let me turn it over here. Actually, no, let me turn it here. You're going to score it at 8 1/4, okay, and then turn it to the 9 1/2 and score it at 1/2, at 4 3/4, and at 9. And then what you're going to do is grab your scissors, and we're going to use the 1/2 inch tabs on the sides to reinforce the side of our notebook, and then we're going to use these bottom squares here to create the pockets. So I'm going to just miter here and here, and miter kind of slightly up at the top, and then I never even thought about really doing this, but this is a great thing. So if you're going to miter like a triangle wedge here, like for example, like if you're going to, you know, just cut out a miter that's right there, a really easy way to do it is to fold the paper where you're going to do that and then just cut it once, and you can go from the corner out and you get a perfect miter. And I don't know why I never even thought about doing that, but I was just reminded of that, or I guess I should say taught that again. I don't know. I've been sick. Forgive me. From Tammy, our leader at Country Craft Creations, and it just makes a nice miter there, and then you only have to do it once instead of trying to go in and do that. So then you're going to fold these tabs over. I feel like I'm nattering. I'm sorry, guys. and we're going to take some glue and come on, glue. Yep. Every time. Okay. So I'm just going to, there we go. Now my glue is working. I even filled up my glue bottle too. So we're just going to fold those long ends over, and that's just going to reinforce. Now, if you want to put pattern paper on the inside of this, you totally can. You don't necessarily have to, but you totally can. I didn't on the other, on the one I showed you, but on the one that was in the notebook, I added pattern paper. So you can do it either way. It doesn't matter. But this will reinforce the edge. When you're in a traveler's notebook, you're using it a lot, and so you want that edge reinforced, okay? So then we'll fold these over. Now, the middle part is up to you how you want to do this. So how I did it was here's your score line right here, and what we're going to do is take a pencil, and we're going to mark an inch and a half in from that score. Okay? And again, what I'm going to do, so I marked an inch and a half here. I'm going to fold this. We're going to cut that middle score out. Okay? So this is going to be cut out, and these two will fold up and create the pocket. So you can fold this out and then just measure it once and then just cut it off with your straight edge. So, whoops, I dropped my mat. So, I'm going to grab my blade here, and I have my ruler here, and I'm just going to line up to where those scores are right there and to my 1.5 inch mark and just cut that off. And then what you're going to end up with is your pocket with the bevel in it. Okay. So then your notebook will close really nicely. Then what you're going to do is you're going to take a piece of paper. This will measure 3 5/8 by 4 1/8. You're going to go from the side, measure in another inch and a half, and then cut it. And that's going to give you the paper mat to cover your pocket if you so choose. Maybe not. Did I do that wrong? I sure did. Okay, I figured out what I did. So when I cut my pocket, I wanted to only go over an inch and a half and make the tick mark and then cut that. What I did was I went over 1 3/4 inches. I didn't read it right. So when I was trying to show you how to cut the pattern paper, I was like, why isn't this working? Well, that's why, because I totally cut it 1/4 inch too wide. But you know what? That's okay. It doesn't matter. You just have to adjust. So if you cut it 1.5 inches over, make your tick mark and then make your slants, this is what you're going to need to cover pattern paper with. So you'll need a piece that's 3 5/8 by 4 1/8. You'll measure over from the side 1.5 inches, depending on if you, you know, do it the same as the angle that you did on your folder, and then slant it. And then that should give you the pattern paper that you want. So since I cut it at 1 3/4 inches, I had to cut another piece of paper. It was the same size. It was still 3 5/8 by 4 1/8, but I measured over 1 3/4 inches, cut my paper, and then look, you get your perfect mat. So that's what to do if you do like I did and cut it too big, or even if you cut it too small. I mean, you can always make it bigger, but you can't make it smaller once you make it bigger. So anyway, that's what you need to do for your pockets. Okay. I hope that doesn't confuse y'all too much. Like I said, I have not been feeling well, and I've been trying to get caught up, and yeah, I'm going to make mistakes, but that's okay. They're not mistakes, right? They're crafting opportunities. Then you just glue those tabs up, and then that makes your pocket. You can cover with pattern paper however you want, and you're good to go. If you used You can use pattern paper to make these folders and just do that. And then they're already covered and double-sided and everything, and it's good to go. So then the other thing that you can do is finish your edges. So if you want to round your corners, round your outside corners, just use your corner chomper because they're going to be kind of thick. Okay, and then the other thing that I noticed in the Graphic 45 notebooks that were kind of cool is, I don't know if you can see it, but they're angled right here. So I have a small angle, and if I could find it in amongst my stuff, corner chomper. So I have a large angle and a small angle. If you use a small angle, it's actually, it's perfect. So what that does is it kind of notches just a little wee bit of an angle and matches the books that are already in my notebook, and then it helps with the elastic going through the middle to set. So that's how you make the notebook, and I'm really sorry for any confusion. So please let me know if you do you know, have any questions about that. But that's how you make a folder for your traveler's notebook, and it is exactly how I made this one right here. Okay, so then let's get this out of the way, and let me show you about your junk journal. So what I did was I went through my old design team packages, and I got some papers from the Simple Vintage Ancestry collection that Simple Stories had, and I picked out some papers that I thought would be fun. Now, you can pick out, you know, you don't have to have the exact sizes either, because having kind of alternating sizes is awesome. So I did that. And then I went through my stash of stuff that I thought I might like to use. So I had this that I got from one of a craft store that used to be close to me. And it is an old paper tablecloth that she cut up, and it has this eyelet at the bottom. So I grabbed that thinking that might be kind of fun to add to my book. Here is some Tim Holtz wax paperish paper that I had in my stash. I've got one of the glassine envelopes from one of the Craftology boxes that I got. When she sends embellishments, a lot of times she'll put them in a glassine envelope, and then if you save them, if you're real careful with them, you can use those. This is another envelope that I had. I don't even know where. It had a staple in it. I forget where I got it from, but anyways, just take the staple out. It doesn't matter if it's wrinkled or not. It's a junk journal. This envelope here is just a very, very old policy, or not policy, but legal giant envelope. Glassine papers, Tim Holtz. Excuse me, good gravy. I am a mess today. These are parchment papers that I found at Hobby Lobby. They had them in their calligraphy section. Picked those up because I thought those looked pretty cool. Didn't have to do anything to them. Tea-dyed ledger papers. Tea-dyed receipt. These are both from the office store that I got, that I tea-dyed. I got a piece of my tea-dyed copy paper. And I use 28 to 32 pound paper, so it has a little bit more you know, thickness to it. I like that. This was something I've had forever, that was given to me when I was trying to learn about junk journaling a long time ago. It's a Western Union paper, totally vintage, totally real, and I'm going to throw one of those in here. This is paper from a, like a moleskin type notebook. I just took the stitching out and grabbed the papers because I wanted some line papers in my journal as well. Then you can also, like, at the consignment shop or the gift store that I have some of my stuff in, one lady was selling these papers, so I grabbed a couple of those because I thought, well, those would look good in a junk journal. I had these old calendar papers. I forget where I got these. These are in my stash. These are just typing paper, calendar papers, and they're great for doing junk journals with. And then I had from another craft store these old giant antique ledger papers that I thought were amazing. So these are going to go in the junk journal as well. So all of these papers these can go in your journal. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with our pattern paper. And this is what I did basically with that other journal that I did. So we're going to start with our pattern paper and we're going to cut these. Now, when I do the journals like this, let me grab it. My dimensions are 6 by 9. So they're a lot bigger. Now you can always cut these down as big and as small as you want. So basically you just need to like cut the strips off your papers. Now you can distress edges if you want. You don't necessarily have to, but you totally can. I'm just gonna cut those off. And then I'm gonna grab my pattern papers here. And I'm going to cut these. Now, I'm going to keep these. Like, some of these, what you can do is you can totally, like, I love that tree. I don't really want to cut it off. I kind of like it. So I'm just going to fold it up. And I'm just going to make sure that it's not going to be past, like, 9 inches. So I'm going to kind of fold it up a little bit. Make it about 8 inches. And then just fold it. And then that'll create like a pocket kind of thing. So I'll put that on the inside of my journal. Okay, you can, you know, score these if you want. But if you like, sometimes these papers will kind of tear a little bit. Totally can, add to the junk journalness of your paper. This one I just cut it 6 by 9. And then I think what I'm gonna do is I like the flowers. That's gonna be my cover. So I'm gonna cut this at 9 and just make that my cover. And then this guy here, could totally do another pocket with this. So again, if you want to, use your scoreboard and do it, or you can just go ahead and just fold it. And you can do it random. That's kind of the beauty of this too. If you do it random as far as height, it adds to, you know, the junkiness of your journal. So we're going to do that. And then basically what you'll do is, oh, I didn't cut that strip off. Okay. So cut your strips off, and then we're going to layer these down. Let's see, we got a pocket here. I'll put that more there. We'll put a pocket somewhere in the middle. We'll do that. Maybe do that too. Just throw them in. And then I think what I'm going to do with these pieces that I cut off, I'll make tags for that later. And then grab your other papers and then just layer them wherever you want. Haphazardly, randomly is great. However, it pleases you to do this. This is a junk journal. There's no rhyme or reason to it. You just need to play. That's all you need to do. So just add, and you can even put them off center as well. It doesn't matter, however you want to do it. Okay, so just add your papers, and this is kind of my process. I just totally am super, super random about it. Now, this is going to be, I think, a little bit, I don't really want to accidentally trim this. So what I'm going to do is, I think what I'm going to do is, I'm going to cut the bottom off just a little bit so that way it'll create a pocket on one end, and then it'll have a pocket here. So we'll have that. I'm going to throw that in the middle. You can make this as big, as full as you want, however you want. Just layer, layer, layer. Okay. Random things. So let's see, what else did I grab in here that I thought would be fun to use? Let's see. I think we're going to not put some of these things in here just for time. Put that one in like that maybe. And let's see. maybe one of my journal papers. Maybe, let's do that. Let's cut this so that I can use it. So I'm just gonna cut down. And I'll use one sheet of this. And that's probably gonna be a little bit too long. So, what we can do is, let's see, let's fold this. I know, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna fold. Actually, no, I'm gonna cut it in half, I think, or half-ish, and then I'll make two pages with it. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so you can see this is totally, you know, however you wanna do it. Okay, however you wanna do it. So I'm just gonna try and even these out so that I have, you know, stuff. Okay, so I have my layers as I want them, okay? And this is a junk journal, guys. This is a junk journal. This is a really super simple way of doing it. Now, the only thing that you need to worry about is making sure that everything is in the middle at some point, because when we sew it, we want to catch our papers, okay? So just make sure that as far as like in the center, everything will catch in your stitching. So I'm just making sure that everything kind of lines up, and I think I'm gonna just fold that over, create a pocket kind of thing, make sure they're just kind of, you know, straight. That's kind of cool. All right, there we go. I think, okay, so I think I have things where I want. Now you can get as fussy with this as you want. Okay, just go through and make sure they're straight. And then the next thing that you will do is grab your clamps and clamp it so that things aren't moving around, okay? And this is a super, super, super simple method, again, of making a junk journal. Okay, super, super, super simple. Okay, so we have our journal. We're gonna sew down the 6-inch line. And what I usually do is I make a template that I'm gonna put down. So what I'm gonna do is measure this, and I'm gonna stick this with the center right at the center line. So you do need a couple things. So you will need something to punch holes with. You're gonna need some sort of a heavy duty sewing needle, and I do have these binders needles that I bought. And then you can use anything. You can use ribbon, you can use waxed sewing thread that's meant for book binding, you can use twine, whatever you want. You just have to make sure the holes are big enough. And then you're gonna need something to punch with, you're gonna need some sort of squishy mat to punch through. And here we go. So I'm gonna sew a simple pamphlet stitch. You just need to make 3 holes. I did this at about an inch, I think it's 1.25 inches up. And again, it is 1.25 inches. It doesn't have to be super precise. Remember, this is a junk journal, okay? And I've got it, when I lined it up on my grid, I lined it up so that the score in the center was at the 6-inch mark, because this is a 12-inch piece of paper. And then you're just gonna take your pokey tool and you're just gonna poke right through all of the layers, okay? May take a little work. All right, just poke through all the layers. I'm gonna turn it over just to make sure that I did, and I did, so I've got my 3 layers. And then grab your needle and your thread, and I should have done this before. Make sure you have a good amount so that you have plenty to tie. This stuff isn't that expensive, so you know, don't be skimpy if you're going to use this kind of thread. This is bookbinding thread. It is already waxed and everything. It's ready to go. And then thread your needle. Now, If you want this tied on the outside of your journal, you start on the outside. If you want it tied on the inside in the middle of your journal, go ahead and do it in the start at the inside, okay? So here's what you do. Super simple pamphlet stitch. So you go through the center and then grab your, make sure you have enough to tie with on this side, okay? And then turn it over. And then go through a top hole. Okay, and pull it. Make sure that you still keep enough. And then go all the way down to the bottom hole, all the way through. All right, to the outside. Okay, and then back up through the center. Okay, now when you come up back through the center, what you want to make sure you do is don't have your strings on only one side of that center. You need one on one side and one on the other. It really doesn't matter. So just make sure that when you do that, you have your strings on the opposite side. Okay, get rid of that for a second. And then what you're going to do is pull tight, and don't be afraid to pull tight. Okay. You really want to make sure that this is bound really well. So I usually like to turn it over, make sure that everything looks good. I don't have any loose bits. And then what we're going to do is tie a knot. Now, if you're using something that's slippery, here is a hint. When you make your first knot and you cinch it down, if it wants to come loose on you, here is a trick. Loop that through one more time. And then when you cinch it down, it will stay, and it will stay, and you won't have to mess with it. And that's a really nice trick to use. And then just do a couple, you know, like a square knot over top, and then do another one, and then you're done. And you could tie it in a bow if you wanted to. You could tie it in a knot, doesn't matter. I'm gonna just tie it in a knot. And then you have your book, okay? So take your clamps off. And then we're going to just fold our book, okay? This one's kind of thick. You notice I didn't use some of the stuff that I had picked out, but this is, you know, this was just a random grab of things that I wanted to show you that you could use, okay? So then we're just gonna fold our book, and I'm gonna use kind of my bigger scraper here, and I'm just going to kind of squish down the binding, and then there you go. So now you could trim the ends off if you wanted to. Now for my traveler's notebook, I kind of tried to make sure that the ends were trimmed because I wanted it to fit in the notebook. For this one here, you don't necessarily have to do that, because this is, again, a junk journal, and you know, you kind of want the junkiness to do. But see, now when we look through our book, look at how cool this is. So you have a pocket here, you can finish it or not. You have your envelope here, or your, yeah, your, excuse me, your paper bag there. You have your papers you can write on. Some of them are upside down, some of them are sideways, maybe a little bit crooked. It doesn't matter, this is a junk journal. But isn't this cute? You could add to this as you go through. You can put pockets in here. You can, you know, put paper. Well, I sewed that in. I got to take that out yet, but. Oh my God, I'm cracking myself up. You can leave that in there, and then you could totally do something with that too, or you can just take it out. I was going to take it out. So, yeah, I'll do that later, but I can't believe I did that. So if you do sew it in, here's how to take it out. You just rip it. And be very careful, and then just take that out. If you use a distressed piece of paper, you could totally leave it in. Totally up to you. So anyway, this is, and there's that envelope that we cut the bottom of it off. We've got a little tab here. You could totally take another piece of paper and like put it on here, make another page. So this is kind of a really super, super, super simple junk journal that you can make using leftover scrapbook paper. You can make this a distressed looking book like I did, or you can use, you know, cleaner papers and put, you know, cleaner stuff in it, whatever you want. The choice is up to you. But this is a really kind of super simple junk journal style. Now, a lot of times what I'll do when I make something like this is I'll take, let's pretend this is like a journal card. Well, actually, let's do this. Let's pretend this is a journal card, okay? So we want to put that on the front as a title. You can put your ribbon under here to stick out and then wrap it around the back and then just glue it down on the back. And then you have a tie here to keep it all enclosed. You could also use giant clips to keep this closed. You can do whatever you want. So that's it. And the stitch we did was the pamphlet stitch. And if I wanted to, if I didn't feel like sewing, I could get my long arm stapler. And then all you have to do is find out wherever the middle mark is. I set my guide like to 6 inches because that would have been roughly the middle mark. And then with all the clamps and everything in place, then just put it in here and then staple in the middle and on the ends. And then you can totally do that as well. Again, you can use ribbons here. You could use twine. If you start from the outside, the bow will be on the outside. So if you wanted to have that on the spine, you totally could. But that's my simple junk journal tutorial using leftover scrapbook papers from your collections. And, you know, again, this is the other example of one that I did. It's a little less full, but you get the idea. That's the same exact thing that I did. You can make them with clean papers, like I said, and I trimmed, once I folded this down, take a straight edge and trim the ends. So I would suggest a very heavy ruler and a very heavy, like, X-Acto knife. Like the one that I just bought is amazing. This is by Fiskars, and this works really well. So if I wanted to trim this down to 4 1/4 so I could fit it in my book, I totally could do that. Again, decorating already pre-made notebooks. These are super simple to make. Artisan craft cardstock and copy paper, and you can make your own using a staple. It's super simple to do. And then you can also do something like junk journaling that will totally match your projects. So there you go. Now that I probably totally thoroughly confused you, that's my tutorial for today. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks for listening to my raspy voice, and I hope that you liked it. So thank you very much for watching. Go visit Country Craft Creations at countrycraftcreations.com. Simple Stories has a lot of different really cool papers. This is Simple Stories as well. Hearth and Home is what I used for my traveler's notebook, and I just think it turned out really cute. So anyways, thank you for watching. Have a really wonderful day, and please see the other designers. They have even better and more amazing junk journal tutorials in store for you, and I think that you'll see more of that coming up in the next year. So thanks for watching. Thanks for your suggestions. If you have any suggestions, let us know. Let Tamara know. We will get stuff out to you and show you how to do some things. So thanks for watching. Have a good day. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.